Hello, this is Jason Lawrence, and this is Home Building Knowledge. Today we're going to talk about window condensation, which in some of our colder climates, when winter rolls around, we tend to get some sweating on the insides of our windows. And usually you'll see a lot of moisture built up around the bottom of the sash, or if you have a casement window, you'll have moisture that's down towards the bottom of the window there. Sometimes it can actually freeze and ice up, and it can kind of overtake the whole bottom part of your window. And there's a pretty big misconception as to what this actually is. So when it's cold outside and it's warm inside, just like a glass of water, kind of the opposite of a glass of water, but you're gonna get sweating. So cold air outside, warm air inside. The warm air up against the glass here, when it meets the cold air, is what's forming the condensation. And the big misconception is that it's the window. You know, I've got bad windows, they always sweat and they condensate and they ice up, and the windows are just cheap windows. Well, that's actually not the case in most homes. So if we're going to talk about a new home, a newly constructed home, these days, and even in the last, you know, 10, 12 years, they're constructed so tight. So they build the house, they frame it up, they put a half-inch insulation board on the exterior of the home, they wrap the entire home with Tyvek, which is a breathable material. It lets the home breathe out, it lets air out, but it does not let moisture inside the house. You have the siding on over top of that. They put the windows in and they caulk and they spray foam around the windows, and everything is sealed so tight, which is great. That's what you want. That's where you're going to see lower costs in your energy bills, but you have to have a way to combat that. So if your house is sealed up really, really tight, and you have a family living in the home, they're putting off moisture when they're taking a shower or when they're cooking. And so that moist air is gonna find the coldest place in the house, which is right here, the glass. So even though windows are insulated, there's still not as much insulation in a window than there is in an exterior wall. So when the moist air in the house finds the window that's cold, that's where you get your sweating and your moisture and your icing up and your condensation. So what can you do to fix this? Well, in most new homes, there's a fan that's installed in one of the bathrooms. Looks just like a normal bath fan, but it's designed to run 24/7, 365 days if needed. So depending on how much moisture your family puts out, if you have five people in your family, you have a dog, you do a lot of cooking, you got teenagers, they're showering all the time, there's tons of moisture getting put out into your house. So you need a way to get that moist air vented outside of the house, and then you need some fresh dry air from the outside to come into the house. So when you do this air exchange, that takes care of the problem that you have with getting all of that moisture and icing up around the windows. So the drier the air in the home, the less, and in most cases, you won't have any moisture on your window. So if you notice that you're starting to get a lot of moisture built up around here and icing there, let your fans run. Even if you don't have a newer house, make sure to run your bath fans a half hour to probably an hour after you shower. Run your exhaust fan in the kitchen when you're cooking. Run those fans. Get that moist air vented outside. One thing that you can do if you've got a serious issue and you haven't done anything like that and your windows are just soaked and iced up, you can do what's called a fresh air exchange. So like I said, get those fans running, but then walk around to each window of the house. Open up each window of the house. Keep walking around the house, open up every window, and then come back and close each window. So what that just did, and I didn't do it for every window in the house, but that gave a blast of fresh, dry, yes, cold, but fresh, dry air into the house. So that helped get some of that moist air out and brought some fresh, dry air inside the house. So nowadays, when they build a new house, they seal it up really tight. They put that special fan in one of your bathrooms that's designed to run nonstop. And then they also put into your home what's called a fresh air intake. So there's going to be a pipe that is, you know, runs from the outside and then it runs to the cold air return in the furnace. So anytime there's a pressure change in the house, so I'm gonna open up this door, close the door, that created a pressure change in the home. And so what that did is it caused the pipe that's running outside from the basement, there's a butterfly flap on that pipe. And anytime there's a pressure change in the home, that flap opens up and it brings fresh, dry air into the cold air return to the furnace. That's then distributed throughout the house. So in most cases, this is going to be a 6-inch to an 8-inch wide pipe, depending on the size of your home. And you'll see this will run up in your basement joists. It'll run outside and there'll be a vent cover on the outside of your house above your basement wall. That's where the butterfly flap is that allows fresh, dry air into the cold air return to the furnace. So that system right there will take care of any moisture that you have on the windows. So if you have a newer built home, run the fans, make sure that your fresh air intake pipe is working properly, and you can have an HVAC company come out and verify that, number one, you have one, and number two, it's working properly. Now, what if you live in a home that's, you know, 30, 40, 50 years old, you just put a bunch of money into it, put new windows in. When they put the windows in, they sealed around them real nice, like they should. Maybe you had new insulation done, new siding put on. And so now your home was built before they were putting these fresh air intakes into the home. Well, one thing that you can do is you can have an HVAC company come out and put this fresh air intake pipe into your house. This is something that can be done in any home, no matter how old it is. And if you have an issue with condensation, even if you're in a home that's 100 years old, run your fans and have a fresh air intake put in by an HVAC company. And I don't have what an exact amount is going to be for them to come out and do that, but it's pretty reasonable. I have to believe it's probably less than $500, maybe even less than $400. But basically what they're gonna do is tap into one of your cold air return ducts in the basement. They're gonna cut out a hole. They're gonna install this 6-inch pipe into it. And then they're gonna run it through your basement joists. And they're gonna pop it right outside of the house, right above the top of your basement wall. That right there is gonna bring fresh, dry air into the house. Your bath fans are running, that's taking all the moist, dirty air and venting it outside of the house. And now voila, come a couple weeks at the most, a few days later, after you've been running the fans, you're not going to have any of this condensation issue on your windows. So that's the number one thing to remember. Once we get into, we're in Wisconsin, so December, January, February, those are the times when you need to make sure that that fan's running. And you'll know if it's not because you'll see that your windows are starting to sweat and ice up. And if you get that, let the fans run. It may take 3 days to kind of catch up and get all the moist air out of the house, but eventually it'll take care of it. And you know, you can see it's cold outside, there's snow on the ground, and windows are bone dry in the house. That's how they should be. And if they're not like that, it's not because the windows are bad 99% of the time. It's not because the windows are bad. It's because you have a lot of moist air in your house and it's not able to find its way out. So that's the thing that you want to remember. Let the moist air out of the house and that'll take care of all your problems. Thanks for joining me. Once again, this is Jason Lawrence with Home Building Knowledge. I have some other videos on my Facebook page that pertain to home building. So if you are in the process of building, or you just built, or you're looking for your builder, check out some of the videos. Maybe they'll prove useful. Again, thanks for watching and have a great rest of the day.